Pop squat.
Coming at ya.
Oh, good. My cat slept through that. So today we've got a song that comes from somebody who left a comment about this rapper, a guy named Locksmith, which I think is a great name. And he is originally Davood Ali Asghari, is his real name. And he is from Richmond, California. He used to be a member of the duo The Frontline, which was a Bay Area group in the 2000s, and he's since gone off on his own. He's been active since about 2003, and this song is called Agenda from Locksmith, and this is him working solo. It's not even 3 minutes long, so this is not going to be a long one at all, but somebody said it was worth listening to, so I am down for it, and let's jump in. So that Can I Kick It, if you don't recognize it, is a line from A Tribe Called Quest, which I know I got their name wrong in a previous video now that I say that. For some reason that came to my brain. That was from a song of theirs, which was quite popular back in the late 80s, early 90s. I forget exactly when. But there you go. Kick it. Can I kick it?
They say we living in a generation that's full of gentrification. Agenda-based agenda's a genuine indication. Bicker back and forth about who controls the premises, but it's all stolen land from the native people, indigenous. The remnants of irreverent is irrelevant. They justify the why through cinematic embellishments. Then we let elitists mislead us, the buffer. Turn working class whites against all people of color. We suffer the same affliction through economic restriction. Focus on skin tone where they pockets have since grown. It's known the black and white concept is just a myth. Until they get profit from it, race didn't exist. From the current face of a felon to the state that we fell in, to the fabrication of bait after Vegas rebellion, it was telling. They won't stop till the spectrum is stretched. Do we see ourselves as one? We can never progress. Can I kick
it? Yeah, so the stuff he's rapping about, he's not wrong. I don't think his statement that race only started to exist so that they could, so that the people in charge could profit off of it, I don't think that's true. I think if you go back and look at history, we have unfortunately around the world have had a real issue with, you are not my people, and so you are less than my people, and so you are now a slave. And that's happened pretty much everywhere. It's absolutely crappy and wrong. And thankfully we've progressed as a society over time. But it doesn't change at all that what he's rapping about is absolutely true. We spend so much time and effort being angry at other people who are in the same position as we are instead of being and doing anything about the people who are actually oppressing everyone. Can I kick it? Can I kick it? Great costuming in this. Well, I don't know if it's accurate, but it's pretty cool. Imagine if I came to your home as a house guest, murdered your whole family before the food could digest. Then waited 100 years to make an unlawful pact and put your grandfather's face on a baseball hat, helmet, a jersey. Early sign of a corporate influx. Separate church and state, mistake God we trust. On the back of your paper deity, how do we break free of the superficially made handcuffs they hand us? Not saying dwell on the past, make them pay for my fall, but you can't expect us to heal and not acknowledge the scars. Back in college, I saw the vast majority of the frats and sororities going dead, still the masses applaud, no passion at all, depending on whether you act or you pause. Like we pay to go to school, to get a job, to pay for school, to pay for school. If we do pay it off, we have to go to a therapist, try to repair the mental damage it caused. They want to... Man, I like his voice. It's very it's not a super distinctive voice, but it's a very good voice, and he has just that little bit of a gruffness to it that comes in just sort of at the end of each word, and I like it a lot. And he's pretty good at rapping, very good at rapping. And there's only a few words that kind of stand out as being a little iffy to get into the beat accurately, and I don't even think that's necessarily all that bad. And I loved the early part where he had a lot of like G sounds, which we could go back to, but it just kind of stood out to me when he was rapping it. It just sounded so great.
That deport the Mexicans, block the Middle East, prostitute the youth and shoot poor people in the streets. The fortunate repeat, pull your bootstraps, but the leather has been weathered. Get tethered after a few laps, and whether you do act or fall back, it's still strenuous. Most of us know this, but the motives are disingenuous. This continuous lack of admission, why we rap with conviction and break our backs to close the gap that you swim in. Every rapper's opinion, basically fair to them. They want to recite the same hype like a teleprompter was read to them. Not responsive, I'm dead to them. My subconscious is lab ruined. I remember the time when we were consider less than human. Three clicks from three-fifths. People are quick to judge, still claiming that he riffs. But still, there's no way to unreap these. My family are immigrants. Does that make me a subspecies? Can I?
Yep. Totally spot on. Huh, surprisingly short video, but absolutely gets his point across. Is really a pretty good song. He's a very good rapper. I enjoyed that a lot. And some really neat stuff going on in the music. In fact, I was listening too much to what he was saying to really think about the music, but it did supply sort of a nice backdrop to what he wanted to communicate, and that's really all it was there for. I mean, it's really basically poetry, effectively, right? He's just talking about the fact that everybody who's in this country and many other countries came here from somewhere else and gets treated poorly because they don't look like the people that live here, even though all the people that live here come from everywhere. It's one of the biggest weird things about America that I can think of is none of us, except for the Native Americans, are actually native to here, and yet somehow we think we're better, we're in any way different than anybody else who comes here. It's garbage thinking. It's absolutely garbage thinking, and anybody who thinks like, oh, people coming over the wall or through the desert or coming over as a stowaway or whatever, like they don't deserve to be here. Well, you don't deserve to be here either because you weren't from here. Like, you're classically not from here. Anyway, I'm going off on a jag that doesn't really matter. Good song. I can see why somebody recommended it to me. I like it a lot. I like him a lot. Definitely got good things to say, and he's a smart guy. I like it. I like it a lot. Be curious to see what you have to say about this. I'm going to have to listen to it again just because I want to pay attention more to the music, because the message was so much of what the song is about that I didn't really pay attention. So I think that's probably a good thing. And the music didn't get in the way of any of that, which is kind of the point. So yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. Hey, Pop Squad. Checking out, we're at 290 followers. Oh my god, nearly 300. Thank you very much. If you are one of those followers, if you are not, please consider following. I would appreciate it. Please like, subscribe, and share. Have a good week. It's Sunday. Oh, my cat's moving over there. That looked weird.